Hello and welcome. I'm Lee, the music reviewer. New backdrop here. I'm actually recording my phone just now, so if the audio sounds dead different, you know why. And today we're going to be doing a quickie-ish review of the new Snail Mail album called Lush. And Snail Mail, if you don't know, are an American indie rock trio fronted by Lindsay Jordan. They're signed to Matador Records, which is one of the best labels going about at the moment. Belle and Sebastian, Carsey Headdress, Julian Baker, Perfume Genius, Kurt Vile. Oh, there's so many great acts on that roster, and the fact that Snail Mail is included on them and is releasing her debut, or see her as a band, but it's mainly Lindsay Jordan at the front of it. So excuse me if I go back and forth between using different pronouns and whatnot, but they are very, I think this is what kind of piqued my interest a little bit. They did have an EP out last year, 2016, called Habit, which was a lot more slowcore-ish, and it'd make things a bit stagnant. There was definitely a lot of potential to be found through that release, though I think a lot of people came out of it thinking, yeah, I'll keep this person on my radar, I'll see what happens. And well, obviously got the interest of Matador Records and peaked. Lindsay's talked about how the DIY scene reacted to them signing to it. All pretty interesting. From all the interviews that I read with her, she's a very interesting person. When it came to my own expectations towards this album, were pretty neutral. I'd heard her mentioned in the same breath as somebody like Julian Baker or like Soccer Mummy, two artists that I'm extremely fond of. I do think there's a real habit of music journalism to put female artists all in the same little bubble just because they're female artists and not actually by their own kind of merit. It's all a different topic in of itself, with the whole genre as a preference, gender isn't sort of thing, because that's exactly how it is. So I went in pretty neutral. I knew that I thought that the Habit EP was fine, so I wasn't going in with high expectations, wasn't going in with low expectations either. I did get a little bit worried though, because there are plenty of acts, I don't even need to name or list any of them off, because you all know the situation when an act gets their first big album and a lot of their appeal or significant sound is sort of becomes sterile. They kind of like polish out to the point where it feels like a factory product. So I was worried maybe that was going to be kind of a situation that would happen. Definitely not though with this album. The first single, Pristine, just feels utterly homemade. The vocals sound lovely, and it definitely does have a bit more of a polish going for it this time around, but I don't think that it detracts or fits into my whole worry about it being totally sterile or void of any real appeal. I think pretty apt considering the name. Lindsay Jordan just shows off her stunning vocals and does so throughout this whole album. I get a real sort of almost Hayley Williams-esque kind of vibe from her vocals, just from how she really does manage to evoke a lot of angst and just a lot of emotion in general. It never feels like she's really like pushing them so much, to the point where it feels almost like over the top, or that everything does feel quite natural, but she does have a real way of just getting that along, that whole vulnerable side. Because where artists like Soccer Mummy and that, theirs are usually from the lyrics alone, whereas I feel that when it comes to Lindsay, she manages to do it just with her vocals alone. And the lyrics themselves doesn't, again, I think that this could easily be written off as being a very like romance heavy album, but I never really think that that's its sole purpose, that's the only thing going for it. I do think there's a lot to be taken away from this, even when romance is used as the vessel to explore things, especially about self-identity, because this album definitely feels a lot more mature and a step up, so you could definitely take that away from snail mail at this point in their career, because they've definitely improved. Like, there's, I think that's just an objective truth here, that the tempos are a lot more varied. It never feels like, I say they started doing, they were kind of more slow corey before, but it feels like there's just a variety going on here. And with Pristine, it feels like it's got like a good solid tempo, so it never feels like it's getting too boring or anything like that. They're obviously, it's a shame that Pristine doesn't open up the album, considering that the song that opens it is just called Intro, and it's a bit of an anticlimax, if I'm being totally honest. It feels like it's starting to build up to something, but it just ends up meandering, and basically just, yeah, doesn't feel like there's any sort of payoff. I think Pristine should have been the one that just opens it up right away. That being said, Lush is an album that pleases more than it disappoints. For every song like Golden Dream or Intro, where it just feels like it meanders, that it just kind of loses its way and never really has much of a payoff, there's always a song like Pristine or like Full Control. Full Control is definitely my favourites on here. I feel that here we get a different side to Lindsay's character, where she essentially gives zero fucks, and it gives her a bit more depth, because she's not just this person that's wallowing in self-pity at points or showing that she overly cares. She gets very melodramatic on this album, and it's for the better. It never feels like it's getting too cheesy or that. It just feels like when she like exaggerates, or when she like manages to use these metaphors and whatnot, she just shines big time here. Especially with her vocals, like when she's like really pushing, like I say, with the whole Hayley Williams comparison, when she manages to do that, it does give it a bit more of an oomph, and like I say, there's more character to it, there's more kind of depth, and it stops this from being just like a kind of more of a shallow indie rock effort. That being said, I would love for the production to kind of fit that melodrama a bit more, because somebody like, the obvious example that comes to my mind, somebody like Laura too, when she's had her projects, she's always had this like extravagant pop stuff, and I know with an indie rock project, you kind of feel like you're having to balance the two. But I feel like there's a lot of rock records that have came out recently where you're able to like add that extravagance without really losing your way much, and that's something I'd be interested to see Snail Mail kind of like maybe experiment more when it comes to any sort of like future effort, because I do think that the melodrama in terms of the lyrical basis of it works very much in their favour. Anytime closes this album out, and honestly it only goes to solidify my view of Snail Mail being like a very worthy addition to the Matador Records roster. It's a stunning wee piece of like indie folk in my eyes, just like a really slow build up, and all just again pays off. There's more moments where it pays off than where it doesn't. And yeah, Lindsay, just her vocals are just completely mesmerizing at points, and by points I mean like even the songs where the songs themselves are weak, she never really like gives a bad performance. It definitely feels like she's starting to just kind of like fit in really well. I don't think this is the album that's going to be like their golden record or their magnum opus or anything like that. I don't even think the band themselves probably think that either. I think this is an album that they're definitely going to be happy with making, and I'm very happy to have listened to it. I just think in terms of production, they've got a wee bit of a way to go to really fit in with the more interesting elements here, like I say, with the melodrama. But it's quite a tight album as well. It doesn't go on for too long. Like I say, it's just a shame that some songs start to lose their way a little bit. But I'm very happy to listen to this Snail Mail record. Got a lot out of it, and I'm very excited to see what they end up doing in the future. In terms of rating, a light 7 out of 10, classic Liam Menzies score here. And that's really all I've got to say about this album. It was meant to be kind of a short review, but I've kind of rambled a little bit. But let me know what you guys think of this album. Give it a listen to if you haven't already. I think there's something that people can get out of this, especially if you're looking for the next big thing. I think Snail Mail are definitely going to be a band that have already been mentioned a fair amount and will only continue to do so. Favourite songs, worst songs, yeah, just all that nice stuff, just let me know. And as always, thank you for watching and listening. Stay safe, take care, stay hydrated.